Today we are going to discuss about the menu planning. Okay, so menu planning is basically a job role of executive chef or sometimes sous chef. So before plan or before fix the menu, they should keep in mind the sequence of courses. Okay, sequence of courses should be follow the 17 course French classical menu sequence. Okay, so before we are going to discuss about the principles of menu planning, we should know what are the 17 course classical menu sequence, okay, and what are the sequence they should have to maintain. The sequence of, they are started from Odof. Okay, Odof means appetizer. Okay, appetizers like prawn cocktails, canapés. Speciality of appetizer is it increases the appetite of the consumer. Okay, next potage. Potage means soup item. Then oof. Oof means egg items. Next, ferinois. Ferinois means pasta or rice items. Now, poisson. Poisson means fish items. Then, entree. Entree means entry of main course. Entry of main course means now they serve the main course item. In India, it may be gravy items. Okay. Next, sorbet. Sorbet is the race between the whole courses. It is very long courses and it consumes more time. Okay. So that's why it is the race time. This is a race sequence. Like in this time, they serve chilled waters, cold waters, water with ice, maybe champagne. Okay. Now, releve. Releve means joint items. Joint items means maybe beef ribs, okay, lamb ribs, etc. Roti. Roti means roast items. Then legume. Legume, vegetable item, then salad, then buffet fried. Buffet fried means cold buffet. Cold buffet like beef tenderloin, okay, which are basically served in cold. Next, entremets. Entremets means sweets. Okay, now savory. Savory means items which have their own pungent taste, like pickle, achars. Okay, now fromage. Fromage means cheese items, like cheesecakes. Okay. And now they serve desserts. Desserts mean cut fruits and nuts. You are confused about the sweet and cut fruit and nuts. Sweet means entremets. Okay. Entremets, the French name of sweet is entremets. And French name of dessert is cut. The French name of cut fruits and nuts is dessert. Okay. Now they serve dessert, which is cut fruits and nuts. And at last they serve boisson. Boisson means beverages. Maybe it will be alcoholic, maybe non-alcoholic. Okay, like tea, coffees, etc. So before executive chef plan the menu or fix the menu, they should keep in mind this 17 course sequence. Okay, menu should be in this sequence. So that is 17 course French classical menu. The principles of menu planning. So when a executive chef or executive sous chef plan a menu, that time you should keep in mind that menu should follow the 17 course sequence and the menu should follow the principles. So what are the principles? Started from types of menu, types of meal, breakfast, lunch, dinner, supper. Okay, so at first you have to keep in mind that which type of meal you serve. Maybe you serve breakfast. Okay, at that time you have to serve smaller courses, light items, light dishes. At the live counter, maybe you serve dosa, idli, okay, dhoglas. So maybe you serve lunch or dinner buffet. At that time, you should serve heavier dishes, okay, varieties of courses, varieties of dishes. At the live counter, you maybe serve biryanis, okay. So it depends upon the meal you serve. Next type of establishments, okay. Which type of establishment you have? Like you have cafe. So at that time, a cafe provides light items, snacks types items, coffees, teas, unalcoholic beverages, maybe sometimes alcoholics also. Okay, so when you plan a menu, maybe you have a restaurant. Okay, then you have to plan different types of courses of dishes, gravy items and their accompaniments. Okay, rice items, etc. So at the time when you plan a menu, then you should keep in mind which type of establishment you have to prepare the menu. Maybe it will be cafe, maybe it will be a bar, maybe it will be for a restaurant. Okay, next, types of customers. Suppose you have a restaurant, okay, and the types of customer mostly you serve is family type customers. Okay, then you should have to keep in mind that how you impress your customer. Then like, then you plan a menu like this. At the time of buffet, at the with the buffet you serve candies also, by which childrens are very happy, and you serve pongals, khichdis with the breakfast or with the lunch. Okay, then the parents, it's for the childrens, so parents are very happy with that. So it depends upon the customers. Okay, you have to impress your customers. So by that thing, you have to keep in mind that which type of customers you have to serve. So at the time of menu planning, you should keep in mind that which type of customer you have to serve. Now, seasonal availability. It depends upon the seasonal availability, like which type of vegetables are available for this season, on this season. Okay, winter season, there are different types of vegetables are very popular, like carrots, beetroots. Okay, so it depends, sometimes it depends upon the seasons also, or maybe there are some special dishes which served in special seasons. Okay, so it's when you plan a menu, you should keep in mind that which type of vegetables are available on this season, which type of dishes are popular in this season. Okay, now occasion. Okay, maybe occasion means festivals. Okay, like maybe you serve halims, maybe you serve Sai Dugra at the time of Ramzan time. Okay, at the time of Durga Puja, you have to serve Bengali type special dishes. Okay, like Ilish Macher Paturi, Chingdi Macher Malai Kadi, Dab Chingdi, etc. Or at the time of New Year, or at the time of Christmas, you have to serve duck, turkeys, etc. So it depends upon the occasions. Next, capability of your kitchen staff. Okay, kitchen staff should be capable. For which type of menu you serve. Okay, like staffs that don't know which type of menu you serve. Okay, they are not properly skilled for those type of menus. Then you have to face a problem. So when you fix a menu or when you plan a menu, then you have to keep in mind that staffs are enough capable or not for this type of menu. Okay, now equipments of kitchen. Okay, then when you think about the staffs at that time, you have to keep in mind that the proper equipments are available or not. Okay, like for chicken butter masala, for chicken tikka butter masala, you need tikkas, okay, which made by tandoor. So suppose you don't have any tandoor, then how you prepare? So you have to keep in mind that proper equipments are there or not. Equipments are on their proper condition or not. Now, value for money. Okay, value for money means it's maybe you have priced your buffet price or food price. Maybe your buffet price is 700. Then, okay, and you serve three or four dishes, and your buffet price is 700. It's not a value for money at that time. Okay, or maybe your one plate chicken butter masala price is $4.99. Okay, almost 500, and you serve one piece of chicken on chicken butter masala, one small piece of chicken. Then it's not a value for money. Okay, because the customers have paid for those dishes, so at that time you will be in a problem. When you not give the value for the customer's money. Now balance. Okay, you have to balance proper ingredients. Okay, at the time when you plan a menu, then you have to check the balance of proper ingredients, proper color combinations of the buffet or the menu. Okay, textures, they are in a proper texture or not, or garnishes. Okay, when you plan the menu, then you have to think about the sequences of the ingredients, of the color, of the texture, of the garnishes. Okay, which look you have to make those type of dishes or those type of garnishes or those type of color combination which looks eye appealing, with by which the customers are attracted. Okay, then you have to think about the balance properly, balance of the color, maybe balance of the texture. Okay, at the end, the last thing is food cost. Okay, which type of menu you prepare, then it should be follow your food cost. Okay, maybe your food cost is 300 rupees, and which type of menu you serve, that cost of the menu will be 500 rupees. Then you are in a problem. That's because of you have a loss of 200 rupees. So the menu, which type the menu you serve, the menu you fix, they should maintain the food cost also. So those are the 10 principles. Okay, executive chef should keep in mind at the time of planning a menu. The types of menu establishment can provide. Okay, so started from table d'hote. So what are the speciality of table d'hote? Fixed menu. Customer can't change the menu. Fixed price. Okay, for a particular menu, have their own fixed price. Limited courses, limited dishes. Okay, maybe 3 or 4 course and dishes should be 60 or 70. Okay, advanced cook. Just because of its fixed menu, so chefs are aware that what they have to cook. So they cooked in advance. Changed, it is maybe changed after a week, maybe it's changed after 3 or 4 days, maybe it's regularly changed. Okay, and in a la carte, table d'hote have their own fixed menu, fixed price, limited course, limited dish, but a la carte is totally opposite. It's have a long sequence of courses and dishes. Okay, and individually price means in table d'hote a fixed menu have their own fixed price, but in a la carte price, a la carte have the lots of dishes, thousands of dishes, and every dish have their own fixed price. Okay, now wide choice for a customer, there are wide choice. In table d'hote, their choices are limited because courses and dishes are limited. So in a la carte, there are thousands of dishes, maybe it follows 17 courses, all 17 courses. Okay, so there are wide choice for a customer. Now next is cartagier is this dish of the day. Okay, it is maybe a special dish of the day. It may be served with the a la carte also. Okay, it's maybe have a pattern, like Monday we serve chicken butter masala, Tuesday we serve shahi tukra, for Wednesday we serve firni. Okay, or in next week we again repeat this pattern. Okay, so it's maybe have pattern, maybe it's chef special. Okay, maybe it depends upon the season, like in winter season we serve hot type of soups. Okay, it's maybe depends upon the speciality in their seasons. Okay, maybe it depends upon the festivals, like in Ramzan time we served halim, we served shahi tukra, okay, which are basically Ramzan special items. Okay, or in time of Bengali Durga Puja or Bengali festival times, we served chingri macher malai kari, ilish macher paturi, ilish mach bhapa, etc. Okay, which are basically served in Bengali festivals. Okay, so that is all about the cartagier. Now it's banquet. This type of menu is basically served in social gatherings, like in marriage party, in anniversaries, okay, in funeral, etc. So they are composed for a certain number of people. Okay, because every party have their own fixed number of guests. Okay, and host means who arrange the party. Okay, who arrange the party, host or host fixed menu on choice. Okay, it means host fix the menu. Okay, because he arranged this party, so he fixed the menu. So fixed menu on choices. Okay, and reasons, maybe it's maybe marriage party, maybe it's for funeral. Okay, so those are the reasons. So that is banquet. Now Next is buffet. Buffet is divided into two categories. Okay, light buffet and folk buffet. So folk buffet is basically lunch or dinner buffet served in time at the time of lunch or dinner. And light buffet are served at evening time, maybe at midnight. Okay. So speciality of buffet, it is very decorative, okay, because they have to attract the guest. Colorful and eye-appealing, well-garnished foods are there. Okay, yes, because they have to attract the guests. So they serve well-garnished colors, which maintain the proper color sequence. Okay, eye-appealing texture. Okay, they serve this type of foods. In light buffet, the timings are in evening or in midnight. For folk buffet means which served in lunch and dinner. Okay, so have the varieties of foods. Okay, yes, because it's served the time of lunch and dinner. Okay, so that's why the courses are more, the dishes are more, they serve varieties of dishes. Okay, lunch buffet or dinner buffet. So that's all about the buffet. And at last, the last thing is cocktail. Okay, cocktail, the item which a main ingredient of the cocktail party is beverage. Maybe it's alcoholic, maybe non-alcoholic, but most of the time that is alcohol. Okay, so that it's basically based on the alcohol drinks. So main ingredient is beverage. But there are some food items which are served is savory items. Savory items means which have their own pungent taste, like pickled or achar types. Okay, so examples savories are stuffed olives, okay, walnuts, gherkins, etc. So those are the menu establishment can provide.